Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Thursday after the Epiphany. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. In the beginning and before all ages, the Word was God, and He humbled Himself to be born the Savior of the world.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who through your Son raised up your eternal light for all nations, grant that your people may come to acknowledge the full splendor of their Redeemer, that bathed evermore in His radiance, they may reach everlasting glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, we love God because He first loved us. If anyone says, I love God, but hates his brother, he is a liar. For whoever does not love a brother whom he has seen cannot love God whom he has not seen. This is the commandment we have from Him. Whoever loves God must also love his brother. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by Him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey His commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
O God, with your judgment, endow the king, and with your justice, the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
From fraud and violence he shall redeem them, and precious shall their blood be in his sight. May they be prayed for continually, day by day shall they bless him.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
May his name be blessed forever. As long as the sun, his name shall remain. In him shall all the tribes of the earth be blessed. All the nations shall proclaim his happiness.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord has sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor and to proclaim liberty to captives. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
At sa ano sa pagpapatuloy ng ating pagninilay, 'di ba, sa ating mission, remember, buong linggo tayong magninilay sa mission kasi nga paghahanda sa ebanghelyo sa kapistahan sa darating na linggo, yung baptism of our Lord. Dito meron na naman tatlong napakahalagang punto tungkol sa mission natin bilang mga Kristiyano. Number one is that yung mission is spirit-led, no? That the mission is always spirit-led. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, as Jesus proclaims, ano, reading from Isaiah. And then if you notice, even the very opening of the Gospel for today, it says, Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit. No? And then, we need to remember, this is the opening, kumbaga, this is the opening salvo of his ministry. No? So again, it is spirit-led. And then, the second point is that, again, it is to proclaim glad tidings to the poor. Nabanggit ko na yan, di ba, nung Kapaskuhan, that at the heart of the proclamation of Christ, the mission of Christ, and our mission is to proclaim glad tidings to the poor. Therefore, yung preferential option for the poor, na tayo ay kumikiling sa panig ng mga dukha. No? Yun yung pangalawang punto ng ating pagninilay sa ating mission. No? And then number three, no, is that it also talks about the fulfillment of this mission. As the Lord said in the final scene of the gospel, he said, "Today this passage is fulfilled in your hearing." In other words, nagaganap na itong pagsasakatuparan ng mabuting balita. And that's part of our mission. We are taking part in the fulfillment of that mission. So maybe just to very quickly reflect a little bit more on each part, no? I think all mission is spirit-led. Kasi kung hindi spirit-led yan, pwede tayong maligaw. No? That's why it's very important for us to constantly discern. And remember, discernment is a discernment of the Spirit of God. What is the movement of the Spirit of God? Ano ba ang galaw ng Espiritu ng Diyos sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay, sa ating pagsasakatuparan ng ating mission? That we must always turn to God, that we may be guided by His Spirit in our mission and our work. No? And in fact, the Lord says, di ba, He has anointed me. And remember, the anointing is with the Spirit. No? Siguro yung mahalaga yung punto niyan. That's why we always have to strengthen that devotion, di ba, and allowing the Spirit of God to guide us. Mahalaga ang paggabay ng Espiritu sa atin. Kaya yung pagkikilatis, mahalaga rin. The discernment. Then the second point is that, again, yung preferential option for the poor, to bring glad tidings to the poor. And kung makikita ninyo dun sa propesya ni Isaiah, concrete yung glad tidings, hindi lang siyang parang magandang balita, oh, we're okay, di ba, nangangako lang, ano, hindi, pero very concrete. To bring glad tidings to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord. So in other words, this preferential option for the poor, this bringing glad tidings to the poor, must be expressed in concrete service. And not just in concrete service, but in concrete, you might say, you know, the turning of the table, so to speak, so that the poor will benefit, no, from the resources of society. I think that's very, very important also. The preferential option for the poor, as Pope Francis would say, it is not simply to give them the crumbs or the leftover, but it is to give them a place in the table. Siguro mahalaga rin natin dapat pagnilayan yon, no? Kagaya nga ng nasabi ko kailan ba, kahapon or kamakalawa, na mahalaga yung pagtulong natin, mahalaga yung paggawa ng kawang gawa. Pero higit na mahalaga ang pagpapabago ng lipunan, ang istruktura ng lipunan, upang patuloy natin maging kabahagi, hindi lamang sila parang nirarasyonan, but they become part even of the decision process. That they are at the table with us. No? And again, even in making the important decisions for them. That second point to reflect on. And then the third and final point is that it says, today this is fulfilled in your hearing. I think yun yung pinaka mahalagang dapat natin maunawaan, no? Kasi yun yung bahagi ng ating misteryo siguro at pagtatanong. Talaga bang nagaganap na itong kaharian ng Diyos sa atin? Kasi nga makikita natin marami pa rin nangyayaring kasamaan. There's so much evil going on in the world. So much suffering caused by choices of men and women. And therefore we ask, no, is it really happening? No, the Lord said, no, today this is fulfilled in your hearing. That the kingdom is already here. And therefore, that should inspire us to continue to work even harder to really establish the kingdom of God. Siguro higit na dapat itong maging sanhi ng ating inspirasyon para lalo tayong magsumikap, lalo tayong magtrabaho para tunay na mapasa atin ang kaharian ng Diyos. So those three beautiful characteristics, graces, blessings of mission. Spirit-led, bringing glad tidings to the poor, and having that confidence that this is already being fulfilled as the Lord has promised. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We now turn with confidence to the Father, whose Son, Jesus Christ, proclaimed the year of favor at the synagogue in Nazareth. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the whole church may be guided by the example and teachings of Jesus Christ in the preaching of the good news, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in government may be mindful of their obligation to show true concern for the poor and the neglected of our society, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have the courage to take necessary steps to make our lives conform to the gospel message, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And again, we'd like to offer our special intentions. We'd like to pray for the intentions offered at this Mass. And today, we'd like to ask you to specially pray for Mrs. Connie Rufino Lopez, the wife of Oscar Lopez, who passed away 2 days ago. We'd like to remember her in our Masses. And we pray also for Mr. Oscar Lopez and for his family. For all of these intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together now, let us pray the panalangin para sa halalan 2022. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa aming halalan 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Jesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami. Lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, ang mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina. Higit sa anumang interes sa pansarili o para sa grupo, mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na namagahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit, Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan ng aming mga isip at puso, nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ng tama ang mga pinuno na tunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung anong higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, Ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Imakulada Concepcion, Patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, we ask you to receive us and to be pleased with the sacrifice that we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, though invisible in your own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours. And begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We pray most specially for our sister Connie. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together, let us spend a few moments of silence. And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love, for and service to one another. Guide our experts instruments in your healing hands to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians in health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that by the power of these holy mysteries, our life may be constantly sustained through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, marami pong salamat and have a good day.
Dahil sa alay kapwa ng Caritas Pilipinas, alam ba ninyong mahigit ng 1 milyong mga Pilipino ang natutulungan natin? Tunay ngang buhay na buhay, lalo na ngayong pandemya, ang pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi, at pag-aalay kapwa. Maraming salamat sa inyong patuloy na pagtulong. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year!